coached by Cobra Frierson. Also, Dylan Forrester, who was on the fight card, will be in his corner. He is the current V3Fights champion. This is his second defense. His first was versus Thomas Klingon. He is 4-0, 5'9", 251, an all-around fighter at 23 years of age. He's also a minister in Savannah. And the good minister looking to make it his second successful title defense.
Dakota's a tough guy. Fearless is definitely a great nickname for him. He was supposed to fight Scotty Stober back in January. Scotty got sick or injured, had to pull out. Dakota said, I don't care, just have someone in there for me to fight. He'll take fights, he's taking fights on one day's notice for us. That's how we got a title shot. And he's steamrolled through everybody since.
Once again, he's putting his V3Fights heavyweight division championship belt on the line. Now we get ready to face, or to take a look at his opponent. Scotty Stunna Stober. As Jason mentioned, they were supposed to fight back in January. They were unable to do that because of a Stober injury. Now it is happening here in March. Stober from Walnut Ridge, Arkansas, and fighting for the LC. He'll be coached and cornered by Tommy Walker and April Nelms. He's also the AA Productions heavyweight champion in Arkansas. He is 2-1, 6'3", 266 pounder. He is a kickboxer at 24 years of age. So the tail of the tape, the real big difference, I would say, is the height advantage that Stober has. Got about a 4-inch height advantage, maybe a 5-inch height advantage on the champion.
There's also a weight advantage. Stober's cutting to make 265, while Dakota doesn't cut at all. So you wonder what Scotty actually weighs today. Who knows how big the weight difference is?
That's a great point. 266 at the official weigh-in yesterday. A couple of chickens and a few hams, and he could be 275 today.
And rehydrate. So he could be 300 pounds. Scotty Stober is a big boy.
And here he comes with a hairdo to add to that whole persona. Scotty Stunna Stober. It's the V3Fights heavyweight division championship.
Definitely great music too, huh?
Good stuff. Feel like I'm at a Club 152 gathering, which will be happening tonight after the fights. Now let's get the formal introduction. Here's Michael Kelly.
V3 Legion, this championship bout is brought to you by Platinum Jewelers. And it's set for three-minute rounds for the V3 Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, the challenger, fighting out of the red corner. He wears the blue trunks with the gray trim. At 6'3", he weighed in at 265.6 pounds. A kickboxer with an MMA record of 2 wins and 1 loss. Representing the LC and fighting out of Walnut Ridge, Arkansas, Scotty Stunna Stober. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears the black trunks with the gray trim at 5'9". He weighed in at 251.2 pounds. An all-around fighter with a perfect MMA record, 4 wins and no losses, representing Cobra Combat. And fighting out of Savannah, Tennessee, he is the reigning, defending V3 heavyweight champion, Dakota Fearless McPherson.
Well done, Michael Kelly. Clint Kolesinski will bring the two together and give them their final instructions.
All right, gentlemen, we're covering the rules in the back. Do I have any questions from the red corner? Any from the blue? Protect yourselves at all times and follow my instructions. Touch gloves if you want to do it now.
Well, you can
see V3 Legion, this is for the belt. Let me hear you make some noise.
I'm not going to attempt to talk over Michael Kelly. You can see that height advantage, though, when the two came together in the middle of the cage.
But at 5'9", McPherson has given up a height advantage every single fight, and he's 4-0.
Round one, here we go for the V3Fights Heavyweight Division Championship.
Look for Stober to try to take him down. He thinks he has an advantage on the ground. Dakota's told me he's better on the ground than he is on his feet, so.
This one a few months in the making. Leg kick there from Stober. Another one. Well, that time McPherson caught it. Pretty good height on that kick from Stover. That time, McPherson with the kick, and then I think he slipped.
Yeah, first time he's been on the ground, on the mat, in this position since he's been in a V3 cage, so let's see what he can do here.
Half guard, side, trying to get the least side control. Right now, leaning that big old body on McPherson. And his nickname, Stunna, maybe that's the first Stunna of the evening, at least in this fight, with McPherson being on his back for the first time, as you said.
You know, heavyweights in this position, it's hard to get that weight off of you.
Little hammer fist there from Stober.
One thing Dakota told me is no one's going to hang with him the later a fight goes because of how hard he works, so we'll see if it gets in the later rounds, if that reigns true.
Now, speaking of reigning, that was a nice little elbow, and Stober wouldn't mind reigning a little ground and pound here. He's trying to flip over McPherson and somehow get in a better position here. Kind of turtling up a bit is McPherson here. Now some ground and pound on the back of the noggin of McPherson.
Well, you see McPherson right back up.
Yeah.
You know, it's hard to get up when someone's on top of you there. He didn't quite finish it, but you see Cobra Frierson over there in the corner, Dylan Forrester.
And more ground and pound, a couple of elbows, some hammer fists. And the arsenal right now by Stober as he's dominated this first round against the champ. Once again, McPherson covering him up or covering himself up. It's all he can do right now. 30 seconds to go in the first round.
He's hanging on to that leg, but he's leaving his head open for strikes.
Another one. Good camera work. Final seconds here, round number one. Now McPherson back to his feet. Stober kind of slips. McPherson tries a couple of shots. He's going to get a little bit of ground and pound at the very end of that first round. But I thought that was a very strong round for Scotty Stober.
You know, Scotty controlled the round. He had the duration. But if maybe it was 30 seconds or so left in the round and Dakota did that, he might have won the round. But I think you got to give that one to Scotty. Here you see him standing with a kick. He just kind of slipped. And that's not a guy you want to have on top of you. Credit to Dakota for being able to withstand that and fight his way out.
Well, a lot of that round, as you see, was Stober trying to get in better position. Hey, kind of squirming around was McPherson, which actually worked to his benefit. But still, when it comes down to it, most of the shots thrown in that first round was by the challenger, Stober.
And you see, Dakota, he actually got full mount. That was a very, very dangerous position, but unfortunately the clock wasn't on his side.
But we'll see if that gives him that added boost, that added confidence to end the round the way he did. Stober on his feet seems pretty good right now. Breathing fairly heavy. McPherson, though, looks to be in pretty good condition. You're talking about heavyweights here, folks. They're not going to, you know, there's going to be a little meat on him. But he seems to be in very good condition. They touch gloves in round two. Here we go. At that little kick from Stober. Wow. And second defense of his title is McPherson beat Thomas Klingon in his first. See how active McPherson gets now in the second round as the two continue to stand.
McPherson definitely looking for that straight right, trying to set that up.
Oh, a big right there. Big right by McPherson. Best punch of the match.
Scotty says he shook it off, but I wouldn't want to get hit by him.
He needs to put a few together.
Now, this is kind of where that reach is taking advantage. You're seeing Dakota's having to leap to get in there and throw some strikes.
Yeah, great observation, not only with the punches from Stober, but also his leg kicks. He has that advantage.
Now he's got Stober backing up.
Yeah, he's attacking him. There's a knee from Stober. Now he'll bounce away. Now it's Stober coming forward. Oh, good left by McPherson.
Wow. Looks like he changed levels but came up with a punch that Scotty wasn't expecting.
Yeah, it looked like he was going to go right. He went with the left.
So Scotty, these leg kicks aren't very effective, and he's going to get caught. You see Dakota trying to catch these leg kicks, and he's going to end up doing it. He's going to follow it with a straight.
Try to go high on
just
that
like
one.
That.
Yep, that was a perfect counter right there from Stober with the right hand. Another right that gets through.
So what looks like Dakota's establishes that kick's not going to hurt him. He's going to let him throw it so he can catch and throw that straight.
A little bit of a lazy kick right there by Stober. You got to watch out because you can get caught with a counter or a takedown.
Stober's trying to keep the distance with those leg kicks.
Get very, very slow with those leg kicks. And you saw Dakota caught that one.
Nice combination there. Went to the body, then came up looking for a head kick.
Now that one wasn't a bad attempt. He missed, but oh, good lead left right there by Stober. But for both these fighters, it's been basically one punch and then back and out. We have not seen really combinations in this fight as of yet. Decent kick right there from Stober. Another one. Oh, and he followed it up with a, here's your first counter. Leg to a left. 10 seconds to go in the second round. Good combination here by McPherson, trying to steal Dakota. This one at the end of the round.
You know, Dakota definitely turned it up that round. I think he controlled it. It didn't go down to the ground. He landed some effective strikes. He was countering those leg kicks. You know, I think you're going into this championship round 1-1.
Well, you got to go out there. You got to beat the champion. He's the champion. And Stober's got to win this thing convincingly. And I think you're right about that second round. Although there was about a minute, maybe 45 seconds in the middle of that second round where Stober got some shots.
See Stober coming in and landing these punches. There was that nice, nice overhand right. Stober tried to shake it off, but
I think he did.
Knee at the bell. You saw McPherson fake low, go high.
And you can see, again, the reach disadvantage for McPherson. But to continue to be offensive and on the attack, he's going to probably have to eat a punch or a kick.
And I think he's accepted that leg kick.
Both fighters acknowledge each other. Both seem to be all right, although Stober breathing heavily out of his mouth. Round three. Here we go. They touch gloves to decide the V3 Fights Heavyweight Division Championship.
Definitely where Dakota said he wanted this fight to be.
McPherson in the black trunks. He is the defending champion. Stober in the blue is your challenger.
Yo, this is the deepest in a fight we've ever seen McPherson go. Ended up defeating Ira Sherrod in the second round via TKO. Every other fight has been a quick first round TKO for him in the V3 cage.
That wasn't too bad movement right there from Stober.
No.
Dancing around in round number three. And a nice combination there. He had the kick and then the left. Like a Superman punch there from McPherson. Now a punch knee combination by McPherson.
Nice head movement, followed up with a left.
Yeah, that was interesting. He ducked a little bit and then came in with the left, as you said. There's an overhand right.
Overhand right again.
Another lead left. McPherson starting to score here in the second, now the third round.
There you see on the poster, Shea Taylor, former V3 amateur heavyweight champion, now an undefeated pro. It's going to headline our card next month.
Looking forward to that. That'll be in Tunica.
Tunica, Mississippi, April 29th. Fitz Casino.
Oh, another lead left by McPherson. Starting to get through that defense of Scotty Stober. Stober with a leg kick here. All these fighters running out of juice. What do they have left? A little over a minute to go.
McPherson definitely taking it to him on his feet. Looks like Stober is, you don't see those leg kicks anymore. You see one, you gotta wonder, does he have enough in his gas tank to finish this minute up?
Yeah, I'm not sure he does, Jason, but let's see.
It's
a good knee. Good knee by Stober.
But Dakotah coming in, throwing blows.
Well, he missed all three there, but it was active. That's a good body punch. Again, going to the body now. That doesn't hurt, right, in the judges' minds.
30 seconds left in this championship fight.
Again, keep into consideration, McPherson is the champion. That does play into the minds of judges. Oh, a big old overhand that missed. 10 seconds to go now in this fight. Lead left by McPherson. Overhand right. Oh, good right there that connected before the horn by McPherson. Good attack there late in this fight. What do you think?
I think Dakotah just took that round a lot more convincing than the second round. I think the second round is going to determine who's the new V3 heavyweight champion. If I had to pick, I'm going fearless Dakotah McPherson.
Yeah, Jason, look, it's a tight fight, but he's the champion. I don't think Stober did enough to steal the belt, in my opinion, but I'm not the judge. We'll see as we'll go to the judges' scorecards. Good performance by the two bigs. Talking about McPherson, who's at 251, and Stober, who weighed in officially last night at 266, but is probably a lot more right now. That's a big boy right there. McPherson trying to get his second successful defense of his V3 Fights heavyweight title. But a pretty good performance by Stober as well. Let's take a look at some of that action.
You know, that reach advantage definitely made it harder for McPherson, but you see him running after, taking the fight to Scotty Stober, especially in the last half of this fight. Scotty Stober was getting the fight taken to him. You know, he tries a knee, but didn't seem to bother or have anything in it. But Scotty Stober, he is a tough fighter.
I think it was very important when McPherson decided that, listen, he has the reach advantage. I'm going to eat a punch or two, but I'm going in there, I'm going inside, and I'm going to start to throw punches. And he did, and
absolutely,
he was successful. Waiting for the scorecards. They are in. Let's go to Michael Kelly and find out who has won this fight.
V3 Legion makes some noise for both of these warriors. What a fight. After three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard for the decision. The judges scored this one for your winner by split decision. And new V3 heavyweight champion, Scotty the Stober.
Well, how about that? That was a stunner, as Jason and myself felt that McPherson did enough to retain the belt, but evidently the judges did not feel the same. Jason Polly, Jeff Mullen, and Scotty Swagger giving this one to Scotty Stunna Stober. He is your new V3 Fights heavyweight division champion, as Dakotah McPherson unable to successfully defend his title for a second time. Let's get a few words with our new champion.
So Scotty, this fight was supposed to happen in January. You were injured, you had to pull out, so you saw someone else get your shot. You've been patiently waiting. Was it worth it?
Without a doubt. I couldn't be happier right now. I would have liked to got the finish, but Dakota's a heck of a fighter, man. He's one of the most respected guys I've ever met in my life. Crazy good guy, and I'd love to do it again. I'd like to give Dakotah a rematch if V3 agrees to that.
I definitely think we would love to see it. It was a striking battle. We've had some great heavyweights from Shea Taylor, who's fighting for our pro belt next month. You took the belt from Dakotah. Let's see how long you can hold it. When are we going to see you again?
I'm going to take a little bit off to heal some nagging injuries I have, but I think within a couple months I'll be right back here defending this title and proving that I'm, despite what the article said about him earlier this week, I'm the most dominant heavyweight V3's ever seen.
Your teammate, Kendon Smallwood's going to attempt to defend his belt for the first time next. How do you see this fight going?
Kendon's way better than this guy. No offense to the other guy, but Kendon's an amazing athlete. I've seen him train. I've seen all the hard work he puts in. Kendon's going to pull this out. First or second round finish.
There you go. Your new heavyweight champion representing the LC, Scotty Stunna Stover.
Congratulations to Stover as we take a look at some of the action. And there you see that decision and the excitement for the pride of Walnut Ridge, Arkansas, as he, look at him, he's dancing. He is really, really excited. Congratulations to Scotty. Coming up next, the V3 Fights Middleweight Division Championship. Keep it right here.